Hello viewers, welcome to Elimu TV, a station whereby we are going to interact and learn together. Today we are going to have our biology from 4 lesson 2, whereby your tutor will be me, Mr. Gerald. We are going to handle the topic on genetics under the subtopic non-disjunction. But before that, we can look at the following lesson goal, whereby by the end of the lesson, you should be able to explain non-disjunction. Welcome. We're going to explain non-disjunction since this involves several activities which involves meiosis and also mitosis. So let us begin as I am explaining this. We are still going to have some diagrammatic representation of the same. So we can say this is the kind of chromosome abnormality that leads to addition or loss of one or more whole chromosomes. If it occurs during the anaphase of the first meiotic division, as we can see, that is the normal meiosis. This is the non-disjunction at the first meiotic division. So we are saying if it occurs during the anaphase of the first meiotic division, two homologous chromosomes fail to segregate and so move on into the next, into the same gamete cell, as we can see from our diagram. And if it happens at the anaphase of the second meiotic division, sister chromatids fail to segregate. Remember, our normal meiosis looks that way, but after now, non-disjunction, actually this is what normally happens. So, this results in half of the gametes containing of the same chromosomes, while the others have none. The fusion of the first type of gamete with a normal gamete of the opposite sex will result in an individual with three such chromosomes, as we can see from our diagram. That is the normal homologous pair plus one extra chromosome. You can see we have got an extra chromosomes there. Non-disjunction causes a disease which is known as Down syndrome, where there is an extra somatic chromosomes number 21. Remember, in human being there are 46 chromosomes, but the chromosomes are normally arranged in order from 1 up to 46. But we are saying now, in non-disjunction, there is an extra chromosome in chromosome 21. So we have an extra chromosome, and this type of disease is known as Down syndrome. Such individuals have slit eye appearance. They have got also reduced resistance to infection, always mentally deficient. They have got a thick tongue. We have cardiac malfunctions and short body with stubby fingers. Higher incidence is among children of older mothers above, as in about 40 years old, and may be due to depletion of nutrients in the father's eggs. So that is to mean if you get children at older ages, you might there is a probability of you getting this Down syndrome, because maybe the father has depleted nutrients in the sperms. Fathers aged 55 years and above also have increased risk of producing offsprings with Down syndrome. Other examples of non-disjunction in human beings include, we have got Klinefelter syndrome and Turner's syndrome. But these diseases, we shall see them in our later lessons. So let us at least follow our later lessons so that we might get into deep of these lessons. Polyploidy is another case resulting from non-disjunction. So generally we are saying that non-disjunction involves some defects, which include the Klinefelter syndrome. We have also the Turner's. We have also the Turner's syndrome, and what we are calling non-disjunction. Briefly, Klinefelter syndrome, individuals have an extra sex chromosome, hence they have a total of 47 chromosomes in their sex cells. Remember, we have said that a normal human being has got 46 chromosomes. But in the case of our Klinefelter, they have got an extra chromosome, such that the total chromosome become 47. You can see it is being presented on our diagram here, whereby we have the normal male, but in the case of our Klinefelter male, he has got XXY chromosome. There is an extra chromosome. Remember, a normal female has got XX chromosome, while a normal male has got XY chromosome. But in case, well, we have got a male who has got Klinefelter syndrome, the Y chromosome, they double. Instead of being XY, they become XYY. Non-disjunction leading to Klinefelter syndrome can occur either during what we call spermatogenesis or oogenesis. It results in half of the gametes containing an extra chromosome and half having a sex chromosome. When the gamete with an extra chromosome fuses with a normal gamete from the opposite sex, an individual with Klinefelter syndrome is produced. Symptoms of Klinefelter syndrome in males include something like infertility. That this is caused by lack of sperm production. We have got what we call underdeveloped testes and reduced facial hair. When I mean the facial hair, I mean face. We might lack the beards. They are actually usually taller than the average with signs of obesity. Persons with the XX chromosome, that is the females, constitution are females who appear relatively normal in most characteristics. Sterner syndrome is where an individual lacks one sex chromosome, as they are only 45 chromosomes. So in the case now of the Turner syndrome is the opposite of the Klinefelter syndrome. The Turner syndrome, we are lacking one sex chromosome. If it is a male, remember we are saying that males have got XY chromosome. So if a male has got the Turner syndrome, we are going either to have the X or the Y chromosome. And if it is for the female, they are going only to have one X chromosome. So the summative number of chromosomes, they are going to be equal to 45. That is to mean they are less than one, because normally you are saying that they should be 46. Individuals with this syndrome are females and show underdeveloped female characteristics. Examples of these characteristics, we are saying they are infertile due to lack of ovaries and small uterus. You can also find that there is no breast and are short in stature. Having done and said that, we are going to have the following activity whereby you are required to discuss non-disjunction in second meiotic division. For this lesson and many more, for much of this lesson, you can refer to KLB, Secondary Biology Students, Book 4. And to get this biology lesson and many more, you can send us an SMS through the number that is on our screen, or you subscribe to either our YouTube or our Facebook page, which are both the Limu TV, or you tweet us at Limu TV_Kenya. Let us subscribe to all these channels and we shall enjoy more of our biology lessons. Thank you.